Hello, boys and girls. We are going to do our next Wit and Wisdom lesson in Ed Puzzle again. So we are on Module 2, Lesson 14, and let's go ahead and get started. Our learning goals today. We are going to identify the stages of the Apollo 11 mission. We are going to practice writing an opinion essay or the introduction paragraph for a opinion essay. And then we're going to identify and explain adverbs in sentences. So our essential question today is, how do people learn about space? This is something we're asking ourselves throughout Module 2. Our focusing question is going to be, how did the astronauts of Apollo 11 learn about space? And our content framing question, we are going to be organizing what's happening in our story, Moonshot. So let's first look at this quote. On October 4th, 1957, the Soviet Union launched Sputnik, the world's first artificial satellite. The moon is a natural satellite. So what do you think a satellite is? Think about that. The Soviet Union had launched a satellite, the world's first artificial satellite. But the moon is a natural satellite. Think about what the moon does and think about what that first artificial satellite might do. And think about what a satellite is. And go ahead and answer that in Ed Puzzle. Now, here is the definition of the word satellite. That we have satellite, and the meaning is an object in the sky that moves around another larger object. So the moon moves around the Earth, and that is a natural satellite. And then the Sputnik was moving around the Earth, so it was a artificial satellite. So now we're told to reread pages 2 and 3, and 40 and 41, look for similarities and differences. So pages 2 and 3 are this first illustration. We're gonna take a look at this first illustration and see what we notice. And then we're gonna take a look at the last illustration in the text. And we're gonna look at similarities and differences. So what is the same about those pictures? What's different? Look at the colors that the artist has used. See what this picture might make you feel. And then do the same for this one. There's differences there, even in just the way that they feel. So I want you to write at least one thing that is the same and one thing that is different. You're going to do that in Ed Puzzle. Now we have a reflection. So we're going to talk about this right now. If I talk about it, I mean, we're going to work on the Ed Puzzle together while I talk to you. So based on how much attention Brian Floca, and remember, Brian Floca is our author. Based on how much attention Brian Floca gives to the events, we think blank is the most important or interesting to him, and blank is the least important or interesting to him. So what you're going to have to do is go through this book, look through here, and look at these different events that happened. You see, okay, we're looking at the moon, and then there's a lot of people who are working hard. I'm just looking at the illustrations. You can do a picture walk to figure this out. And see which parts Brian Floca included a lot of illustrations for. And then look at the other parts where maybe there's not as many illustrations. That's going to tell you why. That's not going to tell you why, but that's going to tell you which event, based on how many illustrations and words Brian Floca has dedicated towards telling you about certain events in here. So look and see What event had the most illustrations and words? Was that the takeoff? Was that the landing? Was that when the astronauts came back to Earth? You look through this book and tell me what you think the most important event is, or what our author was most interested in. And then I also want you to do the same thing and tell me what was least interesting to him. What did he not give us a lot of details about? What would you have liked to learn more about? And then, I know, friends, it's three questions in one, but we'll be okay. Then I just want to know, what did you find most interesting in the text, okay? So you've got three things to do, and you've got the brains and the ability to do it. I believe in you. Finally, we are at our craft question. How do introduction paragraphs work? Now, we talk about in Wit and Wisdom introduction paragraphs, but when we write, I only have you do one paragraph because that's all you're going to have to do as a third grader. But it's good to know these things. So let's look at this introduction paragraph. In Moonshot by Brian Floca, there are many fascinating illustrations. The illustrations on pages 10 and 11 are awe-inspiring for many reasons. First, the illustration shows how suspenseful the countdown was. Second, it is exciting to see the flames shoot out of the rocket. So now, what do you think? Do you think this is an introduction to an expository essay, which is an explanatory, so it explains? Or was that an opinion essay? So think, is that explaining something? Yes, they're explaining the illustrations, but think about an opinion essay. That's when we hear what someone thinks is good or bad. What did they think about it? So think about what this paragraph talked about. They were talking about those illustrations on page 10 and 11, and they said it was suspenseful and then exciting. Do those sound like words you would use in an essay where you're writing about facts and explaining things? Or is that more of your opinion that something is exciting or suspenseful? Go ahead and answer that now in our Ed Puzzle. Tell me if you think this is an introduction to an explanatory essay or an opinion essay, and then tell me how you know. Remember, we're working on explaining your thinking in Module 2, and I know you can do it. All right, now we have another introduction. It says, Moonshot by Brian Floca describes the stages of the Apollo 11 mission. There are other books that also tell about the Apollo 11 mission. Sending men to the moon was dangerous. Why is this not an example of an opinion essay introduction paragraph? So that kind of helps you. That question just before this one, that was an opinion introduction. Now they're telling you this one is not an opinion introduction. Why not? What's missing? Think about that. What is the opposite of an opinion? Is that, do you see the opposite of opinions here in this paragraph? That would be one reason that it's not an example of an opinion, but you need to tell me what the opposite of an opinion is. You can't just say it's the opposite. All right, friends. So put that in Ed Puzzle. Why is this not an example of an opinion essay introduction? All right. On your handout, this is actually one thing we're going to do. One last thing we're going to do in Ed Puzzle. So, where is a place in Moonshot that Brian Floca could have used more or fewer pages to describe an event of the Apollo 11 mission? Write the introduction paragraph for an opinion essay. That sounds tricky, friends, but I actually have like a fill in the blank for us. So, you'll see that in Ed Puzzle. Let's look in your book, and we're going to find somewhere in, well, let me hold the book the right way. You're going to look in your book, and you're going to find an event where you felt Brian Floca either used too much, and he should have used fewer pages, or not enough pages to describe an event. So this is kind of what we were talking about at the beginning of our video. And now it's time for you to write about it. And you're going to remember our book's name, our book's title is Moonshot. It was written by Brian Floca. And then we're going to fill in the rest of those blanks to answer this question. Now let's move on to adverbs. Writers use adverbs to elaborate on a topic with descriptive details. They add clarity and they strengthen sentences. Adverbs describe verbs, adjectives, and other adverbs. They typically end in ly. And we've started to talk about this in our small group, so this might not be news to everyone, which is great. Let's keep going. So here's our word, adverb. And the meaning is a word that describes a verb, adjective, or another adverb. So now we have this table that we're going to fill out together. What I want you to do is look through some sentences in Moonshot for verbs. Find action words. And then check to see if an adverb is describing the verb. So you're going to look through this book and you're going to find an adverb that tells us when something is happening. So when is that verb happening? How is that verb happening? Where is that verb happening and to what extent? And then here is our exit ticket. That means that's the last thing we're going to be doing in Nearpod. Nope, sorry, not Nearpod, Edpuzzle. So you're going to write a sentence using one of the following adverbs: often, always, early, more, or slowly. That's it. And then you're done. Now let's talk about what you're going to do in Seesaw. So on Seesaw, you're going to have a spot where you're going to write down three important events from Moonshot using words relating to time and sequence to describe the correct order. So you're going to need to use those correct transition words. First, then, next, last, or something to that effect. Okay, guys, you need to use your sequence words when you describe three events from the story. And then you're going to put six events from the story in order. So you're going to use this handout, and you're not going to have to cut anything. It's already there for you. You're just going to put them in the correct order on the handout, and then you're done. So you'll look, we have event one, number two, number three, number four, number five, and number six. So then you're going to look at all these events and put them in the correct order. All right, friends. That is our Ed puzzle for the day. You are doing great. I hope you're enjoying the Ed puzzles, and we will keep going with them. All right. Bye.